the Sport of Kings, your window to the world of horse racing. Few horses have ever won a Triple Crown. On this episode, we'll look back at one that has, arguably, the greatest horse ever, Secretariat.
It was a moment in racing history to be savored. What had seemed for a few seconds to be a match race between Secretariat and the now shattered sham became...
Could racing grind to a halt in Vancouver? It's all in the hands of City Council this Tuesday. They'll consider whether or not to allow Hastings' proposal for slots to move on to public hearing.
I think it's important to other stakeholders as well, people who want to use this park.
Three-year-old fillies battle for supremacy in a very important allowance race at Hastings on our race of the week.
I would think that, you know, if they want to go, they're going to kill themselves too.
It's Smarty Jones on the road to a Triple Crown in the 2004 Preakness.
With this being racing's biggest day because Smarty Jones is trying to become the 12th horse to win the Triple Crown in the Belmont Stakes this afternoon, our opening segment, we're paying tribute to perhaps the greatest racehorse of all time. It is Secretariat, the feature you're about to watch. It was produced by the late racing historian Joe Burnham. Let me tell you, sit back, relax, and him and I are going to enjoy.
The Triple Crown, Kentucky Derby, Preakness, and Belmont Stakes run in three different states within a period of 5 weeks is the Blue Ribbon event of the American turf. By 1973, 25 years had passed since Citation was crowned our eighth Triple Crown winner. Then came Secretariat. By bold ruler from the Prince Quillo mare Something Royal, he had been named Horse of the Year at two, first colt in history so honored. On Derby Day 1973, Secretariat topped a fine group of colts that included Sham, Our Native, and a to-be-great Forgo.
And they're off for the lead. On the inside, that's Angolite for the lead. On the outside, Checky Green. Royal and Regal, then on the rail, it's Restless.
Into the first turn, although Sham was in excellent position, Secretariat was last.
By the stands for the first time, Checky Green.
Challenging his Sham, and he's now got a head in front. Now Checky Green responds to the challenge, and those two are heads apart. Royal and Regal is third and holding on. Goldbag drops back. Secretariat is fourth and moving up on the outside, and is now third, and moving at the leaders as they come for the head of the stretch. They're at the head of the stretch, and Sham is the leader. He leads it by a length. Secretariat is in the center of the racetrack and driving. Checky Green now drops back. Coming on a bit is Forgo, Our Native on the outside. Now and then the stretch, it's Secretariat. Secretariat on the outside to take the lead. Sham holding in second. It's Secretariat moving away. He has it by 2.5.
Running each quarter faster than the one before, Secretariat smashed Northern Dancer's record by 3 lengths, 1:59 2/5. By Preakness time, 2 weeks later, owner Mrs. Penny Tweedy, trainer Lucian Lauren, and jockey Ron Turcotte were celebrities, and Secretariat drew the largest crowd in history to Pimlico, a crowd which would break through and line the inner rail dangerously during the stretch run. In moving across the track, the crowd somehow damaged the electric timing device, and the running time of this Preakness would be forever in doubt. The least bothered was Secretariat, who would soon run one of the most electrifying races in Preakness history.
And they're off for the early lead. That's Deadly Dream on the outside at Coletage. Then it's also Torsion on the outside. They're coming by us. It's a Coletage getting it, and he's moving away by about 2.5 as they pass the stands. Settling into second, Torsion. Sham has good position, third on the rail. It's another 3 lengths back, Deadly Dream. Then Our Native and Secretariat is last again as they move into the first turn. They're into the turn. A Coletage has it by 2 lengths. Torsion second by a length, and then Sham third. Sham under an easy hold right now, but here comes Secretariat. He's moving fast, and he's going to the outside. He's going for the lead, and it's right now he's looking for it. Ronnie Turcotte sends him alongside a Coletage. Here we have it. A Coletage is the leader, but Sham, rather, Secretariat is right alongside. Then still further back, that is Sham now going to the outside in third. They're on the turn. Here's the race, folks. Secretariat trying to hold it, and Sham is driving to get him. Head of the stretch, Secretariat, 2.5. jam under a strong left-handed whip. And he's making his run now, but it's still Secretariat holding on. Secretariat by two lengths. Jam driving second. There's a strong left-handed whip again by Tinkai. He goes to it time and time again, but Ronnie Turcotte has his whip put away, and Secretariat has him put away. He's beginning to draw away. It is Secretariat. He's coming to the wire. He wins it by two and a half, almost three. Jam, an easy second. Our native third. A Coley dog for a definite...
By Belmont time, 3 weeks later, Secretariat fever had become near hysteria in New York. The color and charisma of majestic prince, the size and symmetry of man of war, an immense chest and tremendous drive all his own, all joined with a perfect temperament to make Secretariat the focus of the racing world.
Secretariat away very well, has good position on the rail, and in fact is now going up with the leader. They're on the back stretch. It's almost a match race now. Secretariat's on the inside by a head. Jam is on the outside. For the turn, it's Secretariat. It looks like he's opening. The lead is increasing. Secretariat is widening now. He is moving like a tremendous machine.
It was a moment in racing history to be savored. What had seemed for a few seconds to be a match race between Secretariat and the now shattered Sham became a rout. The chestnut marched into history in the most emphatic way possible, a winner 31 incredible lengths in front of the next horse, establishing a new American record for the mile and a half. Later, Secretariat would defeat older horses in the Marlboro Cup on the main track and in the Man of War and Canadian Championship on the grass before retiring to stud at his birthplace, Claiborne Farm.
Magic Wisner beginning to move up now on the outside. He's 7 lengths from the lead, and War Emblem is toiling as they turn for home. Medaglia d'Oro, Sunday break.
Only 11 horses in 136 years have ever taken home the Triple Crown. Smarty Jones, the third in as many years to try later today. You can watch and wager with live simulcasting at Hastings or Fraser Downs. Catch the Belmont Stakes from New York. Post time, 3:38.
Medaglia d'Oro toward the rail. They're coming down to the finish. A huge upset is looming here under the line. Sarava has won the biggest long shot in the history of the Belmont Stakes at 70-1. Medaglia d'Oro was finishing second there. And farther back, Sunday break. And a huge disappointment today for War Emblem. He was off poorly, never got rolling, and faded in the stretch. So once again, the Triple Crown will go unclaimed, but a worthy winner today in Sarava. Well, all right, Tom Durkin.
Tommy Walski's Sport of Kings is brought to you in part by Equine Insurance Underwriters, serving the horse racing industry for all their insurance needs since 1980. Call Equine Insurance Underwriters at 293-1531.
The Thoroughbreds are back for another exciting season of live racing. So get to Hastings this Saturday. First live race, 1:03 p.m. Always free admission and park and play coupon. Hastings. You won't know until you go.
Your dream home may be closer than you think. With a little imagination and some help from the good people at Tip Top Carpet One. With the fine quality flooring products for every need and expert service and advice, let Tip Top Carpet One complete your vision. Tip Top Carpet One, fulfilling dreams from the ground floor up. Hi. So call in Abbotsford or Langley.
Live racing in Fraser Downs every Friday and Saturday until June 19th, post time 7 p.m. Simulcasting of North American and International Thoroughbred and Standardbred Racing 7 days a week. And don't forget to drop by the new Fraser Downs Gaming Center, featuring 200 slots, including Progressive Machine. For more information, call 604-576-9141 or visit our website. Fraser Downs, your all-source gaming center.
The Thoroughbreds are back for another exciting season of live racing. So get to Hastings this Saturday. First live race, 1:03 p.m. Always free admission and park and play coupon. Hastings. You won't know until you go.
This Tuesday, the horse racing industry here in British Columbia is asking your support to attend a crucial meeting by the Vancouver City Council relating to slot machines at Hastings Racecourse. Now, this is not a case where you say, well, we'll let the other guy do this. This is a case where you have to do it. Support horse racing by attending the Vancouver City Council meeting on Tuesday and say you want slots.
We hope that City Hall will allow it to go to public hearing. We're very involved with what we've heard from the visioning process. We agree the park needs to be greened and we want to be part of that. We understand some traffic concerns and of course community concerns. We want to address those issues.
It's going to be either a direct turn down for slot machines, in other words it won't go forward to hearings, or it will. And it's significant to us that we get public hearings on the issue and ultimately get slot machines at Hastings Park. And I think it's important to other stakeholders as well, people who want to use this park.
I think it'll bring a lot of employment, a lot of different people, people that, jobs, for job security. And I think, I went to Fraser Down and I saw people's faces and I was just impressed on how happy people were. Like, they were really, really happy.
It is going to be tremendous. It is going to be tremendous because it will help revitalize the horse racing sector.
I think if we can be successful with our application and we can really re-energize the facility, so bring it up to 21st century standards, I think that, and then also will have an effect on purses. We'll see an increase there, which will attract more owners to British Columbia to race their horses here. Breeding will spiral upwards again, so I think with good field sizes and a real improvement to the facility, I think it'll be good for customers, owners, employees, everybody that's involved in the sport.
I think it's going to be very important for people who support horse racing, who enjoy horse racing, and for people who just want to enjoy this park in a grander fashion to be there and voice their support for slot machines. And instead of thinking of saying slot machines, think of it as supporting a funding mechanism to make this vision come true.
This week, it's all about the jockeys at Hastings Racecourse. First jockey Fernando Serna is back riding after spending the past month in physiotherapy. Last season, Serna injured his leg in a spill. He returned to ride this season, but had to leave again when he went down in another spill.
I know it's going to be a little bit tough for me to start to get in some winners, but I trust that with the time, a couple weeks or once I start winning races, so everything's going to come back. Because right now, everybody, all the riders, they have their own horses, so obviously trainers have to stick with them, so I have to find months.
There's a new face at Hastings Racecourse joining Serna as a rider this season. Jockey Lauren Kaiser has traveled all the way from Trinidad to ride right here in Vancouver. Kaiser, who is friends with fellow Trinidad native jockey Anthony Stevens, experienced success in his home country, but now he's going to try his luck right here in Canada.
Well, I've been placing up a lot, and I've been doing pretty good. A lot of the owners are really impressed, and they want to see me a lot more and a lot more horses. So they're willing to give me a chance, and that's great. That's what makes it so much more better.
And in more jockey news, apprentice jockey Mark Lawson will no longer be riding here at Hastings Racecourse. Lawson will be returning to his home in England after finding himself homesick and battling weight issues. Next Saturday, June 12th, marks the 115th anniversary of Hastings Racecourse. In celebration, there will be an open house at the playground entrance at the track. Everyone is invited to listen to presentations, tour the track, and meet the members of the Save the Track Coalition. The open house begins at 11 a.m. And remember, racing fans, today is a big day in racing. It's the Belmont Stakes. Come out to Hastings Racecourse or Fraser Downs to see if Smarty Jones can win the final leg of the Triple Crown. I'm Carmen Thomas, and now you're back on track.
Cooper, cut it out. Now, are you ready for another Belmont